blazing, chronic, catapanic every day. On my black, we rolling blunts for me, there ain't no wood.
What up, YouTube? This your boy Down Low back with another album review. So, no mixtape review this week, man, simply because there was a bunch of good music to drop, but nothing really that damn impressive this week, man. So I'm like, fuck it, I'ma keep it fucking moving. But before we get to the review, let's talk about what's going on in the music industry, man. So Macklemore came out in an interview and started explaining his song White Privilege, in which he pretty much came out and said that he benefits the most out of white privilege and shit. And I'm like, no shit. Do you really think it's a coincidence that the most grossing, profitable, independent artist out there right now is Macklemore and Mac Miller? The combination of white privilege and white supremacy, man, is a fucking beast. And it puts people on top that really didn't deserve to be there, like, just musically speaking. I respect Macklemore, I respect Mac Miller for doing their business fucking correctly. But skill-wise, they're not like Eminem, who deserved his fucking slot. Both of these rappers are very weak in comparison to the competition that's out there right now. But pretty much that white privilege gets them acceptance into the pop and mainstream audiences and shit. But anyway, on to today's album review, and it's to that Big Sean, Hall of Fame. And you know what? A lot of guys out there was anticipating this one, saying that this one is gonna possibly be the best of the year type shit. And I got to say, it's good, but it's not great. See, there's three types of songs off this album. There's the damn good ones, which are the Nothing Stopping You, It's Time, and That All Figured Out. Then you got your okay, which is the vast majority of this album. Like, examples of this are You Don't Know, Sierra Leone, and Set Ablaze. And then there's the ones where you're like, okay, I just skipped this one. And that's like that MILF. But overall, every track, man, you can find something good about them, whether it's the lyrics, whether it's the beat. But there are really no classic tracks off of here, you dig? Now, let me put it to you like this. Which would you rather have? The album with 2 to 3 classic songs that you're going to listen to for the rest of your life? Or the good album that got a whole bunch of good songs, but that's just gonna fade away after a year, maybe two? Personally, I demand full-on classic albums, but yet, if I had that option, then I'm going with the 2-3 classics over this. Now, Big Sean is spitting throughout, man. He got excellent punchlines, dude. He got pretty damn good beat selection as well, but I feel at times he conflicts with his production, making the songs not as great as they could be. Overall, Big Sean does show his potential on this album, man. He definitely can make that classic album. Literally, music-wise, song-wise, he can fucking do it. He just has to do that shit. He's at the point where no one can explain to him how he's going to make his classic. He really has to do that shit and figure it out on his own. And hopefully he remains hungry enough to actually do that shit. But overall, I give this album, man, an 8 out of 10. But anyway, on to today's article from downloadpad.com. And today's article is about how young rappers always making the mistakes of getting downloads and thinking that's the equivalency of sales, when obviously it's not. And you can look at some of the most famous shit that's been going down as of recently, man. When Jay-Z released that Magna Carta Holy Grail for free online, he got 1 million downloads fucking overnight. People couldn't keep up with that shit. But now look at his sales, man. It seems as though those 1 million free downloads haven't fucked up his sales, but yet he's still at 840,000. And this album has been out for fucking weeks, man. People will go out and get shit and download it just because it's fucking free. That is no indication that these people are going to buy your shit. It's merely just some talking points so you can get a good deal from a record label if you're going in that direction. Or it's a good indication of how big your fan base actually is. But ultimately, sales is the bottom line.